This is EY Stream. He thinks he looks pretty cool, but ProGamer27 doesn't think so. Please make him feel better and follow his Instagram and Twitter. Go! Go do it now! Chess? A lame! Like, while everyone else out here is wanting a cave update, a nether update, a mountains update, a swamp update, I'd be here like, give me a chest update. Just kidding, guys. I would probably much prefer a cave update, but I still think we can all agree that chests don't really have a lot of functionality besides storing stuff, and they are long overdue for an update. Like, these things have been around since literally the beginning of Minecraft. Wouldn't it be great if we could use chests to, I don't know, clear items, follow us around, and basically act as like an additional storage thing? Or maybe even be able to lock them so people can't steal our items. I think all of those features would be much appreciated by most of the Minecraft community, but Mojang or Mojang has said no. But today, I'm going to show you how you can get around that, guys. How you can upgrade chests to do all those things I mentioned in today's video in your very own Minecraft world. So if you guys are excited, make sure to leave a like down below and slap the subscribe button to Ling Ding Ding to never miss an upload. So you get the coolest tips and tricks in Minecraft before any of your friends do, like, I don't know, how to upgrade chests and get secret chests in Minecraft. That's pretty cool. So you can show off to all your friends as long as you guys are subscribed. But without further ado, let's start checking out these chests. As you guys can see here, we have a ton of secret chests that you can upgrade over, well, the standard chest here, which is very, very boring. Now, of course, guys, we have their crafting recipes in each of these chests. But for these crafting recipes to work, you will need to do something else, a very special step to make sure it all comes together and works, which I'll be showing at the end of today's video. So if you want to get these on your own world, before you try using these crafting recipes, you will need to stick around to the end of today's video to see this secret step. But without further ado, let's get straight into it. So our first chest of today, guys, is the jewelry chest. Now, for those of you who can guess, if you're storing jewelry in a chest, you probably want it to be lockable. Yeah, basically what we've all been wanting for a long time. Chests that can be locked, and finally, you can do that with this brand new chest called the jewelry chest. So let's go ahead and craft it, guys. It's iron across the top, two glass panes, diamond in the middle, and then with our iron here, we've got iron on the bottom. And check this out, we have our jewelry chest. Look at this bad boy. So let's go ahead and place this bad boy down. Now, to place one of these chests, they're a little bit more heavy duty. So what you got to do first is shift like this, and you'll see this little hologram thingy appear, and that's where your chest is going to appear. This is important because once you put down one of these chests, you can't just break it with your fist, obviously. Otherwise, there'd be no point in locking the chest, guys, because people would just come along and break it. So let's go ahead and place it down. Voila, check this out. This is the jewelry chest. Now, it doesn't look like your conventional chest, but in there you can see that's like where your items are kept in the jewelry section. But at the moment, we can't open it. You guys can see I'm clicking away. I can't seem to open this thing at all. And that's because you can see the glass here is all covered up. It's locked. So we're going to need a key to open it. So to do that, let's go ahead. You're going to need a gold ingot and then a gold nugget on top here. That's going to give us a key. If we go ahead and click it the first time, this is going to tame our chest, essentially. I don't know how else to explain it, but basically now the chest is linked to you and this key. So now if we go ahead and use the key, let's go ahead, bang, you'll see that the thing inside spins, and now we can go ahead and open this chest. We can put some stuff in it. Let's put some endstone brick walls in here. I don't know why you would ever want to lock this way, but now if we go ahead and lock the chest again with our key, check this out, guys. I cannot open it. Like, literally, look at me, look at me. I can't open the chest. It is now officially locked. And this is really great because it means that your friends who always steal your stuff, I'm looking at you, Ethan. Sorry, guys. I'm just having a little bit of a moment. They can't steal your stuff anymore. However, there is one flaw to this chest, which makes it not the superior choice. I mean, it looks pretty awesome. So, I mean, I guess it's a good design block. But here's the thing. If someone has an iron ingot and some iron nuggets, they can make a crowbar and bang, they can unlock your chest without needing your key. So, if they know how to make a crowbar in Minecraft, you're in a bit of strife because they can basically break your chest. If only there was a chest that used a key but couldn't be broken by a crowbar. Yeah, of course, guys. There, of course there is one. Check this out. This here is the safe chest. Now, this thing is a little bit more expensive, coming in with 8 iron blocks. But boy, oh boy, is it worth it. So let's go ahead and craft this bad boy. This thing is a beast. We'll also need a brand new key to sync up to our safe. So here we go. We've got our safe here. Let's go ahead and place this thing down. So you have the little hologram up here and place. There we go. You can see this thing is a little bit more beefier than this one over here. This one's got glass, so it can be broken with a crowbar. This one is basically a bedrock safe. If you go ahead, tame it with your key, of course, it works the same thing. You can use your key like so. You'll see the little safe door opens. Isn't that awesome? That animation is so smooth. And now you can go ahead, chuck stuff in here. We're going to keep the key to this chest in here and the crowbar so nobody else can take it. Then you go ahead and lock it up with your key and boom, check that out, guys. And now I can't open this chest at all and I can't destroy it either. Even if I had like a diamond pickaxe or something and let's say I enchanted it, let's say enchant at P efficiency 3, right? Even with an efficiency 3 pickaxe, nothing. Zero nilch. You are not breaking through that chest, guys. So there is our jewelry chest, our safe. But let's say you wanted to use your chest for not storing items, but actually clearing items. Right now, guys, the only way you can clear your items is setting up a lava pit, chucking your items in there, but that's risky because, I mean, it's lava. But also, items can jump out. Wouldn't it be great if there was a much safer way of doing it? Yes, it would be. So check this out, guys. This here is the trash can safe. So what you're going to need... Oop, I accidentally took the iron from this chest. Let's just put that back there. All right, we're also going to need stone cutter and these iron ingots. Here, this is the trash can chest. To build this, you're going to need iron across the bottom, like so, a stone cutter in the middle, and iron ingots on the top. Check this out, guys. The trash chest. If we go ahead, we'll make some room here. Go ahead, and we'll place this out again. The little holograms appear, and bloop, there we go. This is our trash chest. Now, it does look quite similar to our safe over here, but this one doesn't need a key. All you need to do, go ahead and open it, and you'll see it opens like so. Then you can go ahead and put stuff in here. And now, if we go ahead and close it, check this out, guys. It's going to shake. It's going to go... And open again. And boom. Your items are gone. This is the perfect way to get rid of all those yucky, useless items you need, don't need. Like dirt. 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 And you know that one friend who always steals your items. They can jump in there as well, guys. Just kidding. Don't chuck your friends in. Basically, this is an incinerator chest. It's pretty cool. But don't chuck your friends in there. All right. So that is our trash can chest. The next one is... an interesting thing. I don't really know how to describe it. It's kind of like a robot chest. I'm worried it will take over your Minecraft world, but hopefully not. It's essentially a wolf or a horse that follows you around, but it also stores items. So you guys will see what I mean in a minute here. Let's go ahead and craft this thing. So iron, diamond block. Now, this is expensive, but you'll understand why in a second. So this here is the chest driver. So let's go ahead and place this down. If we go ahead, bloop, just like that. As you can see, this guy is not just your ordinary chest. He actually has eyes and eyebrows, which I don't know how I feel about that. Chest, I don't think, should have eyebrows. And he has a mouth, guys. And of course, at the moment, we can't use him to do anything. We need a key to make him our chest as, you know, the other chests have been done. So let's go ahead, click him on with a key, and is that... So I've actually made a mistake here, guys. A conventional key is not going to train a robot chest. I should have known that. You're actually going to need some redstone dust. If we go ahead and use that, there we go. So now... we have tamed our little friend here, the chest. And as you see, he's going to follow us around. So this is great if you're going on a journey somewhere. Or let's say you're moving house and, you know, you have to move tons of items from your old house to your new house. All the chest movement, it takes forever. But now you have this robot chest who can follow you around carrying all your items. And you can have like a whole army of these things. Unfortunately, they're not going to defend you. But yeah, it's pretty cool. Then you can use your key to go ahead and unlock him. So this is his open state. And as you can see, you can chuck items in here and then you can close them up with the key again. So yeah, really, really great idea. And like, I could see this being so useful if you're transferring a ton of items or going exploring. You could have like four of these guys and just have them follow you around. Now, let's say, just like a wolf, sometimes you don't want to take these guys around with you. Really simple. All you got to do is crouch, click, and boom. It powers down just like that, guys. And now Mr. Chestman is not going to follow us around like an absolute creep. All right, there we go, guys. That is Mr. Robot Chestman. We're going to just leave him over there because it's kind of creepy with his eyes and his eyebrows. That is one thing I'm not a fan of. Next chest, guys, we have our locked chest. Now, this chest here is more of a variant of our jewelry chest. Essentially, our jewelry chest looks cool. This one doesn't look as cool, but it doesn't require a diamond to make. So that is a huge advantage, at least in my opinion. Doesn't look as cool as the jewelry chest, but if we go ahead and place this thing down, all right, and bloop, just like that, you guys can see it works exactly the same as the jewelry chest. Basically, you make a key, you go ahead, tame it like so, and it unlocks and locks just like that. Now, the difference here is with this one, you can only use the designated key to unlock it. So we can't use any other key to lock or unlock it. Whereas this one, you can actually go ahead and use any key to open or close it, as you guys can see. So I guess this could be useful if you want to have a chest that's shared between a few friends. You could give them all keys and it wouldn't just be tied to one key, guys. So yeah, that's really cool. But let's say you want to modify these chests even more. First off, how are you guys not satisfied yet? We have a ton of crazy awesome chests. Okay, look, I understand I wouldn't be either. You can actually go ahead and create two other things here. The first one here requires 3 iron nuggets, and the other one requires a ton of sticks. So with the sticks, guys, here, you can put them around in a chest formation. It's going to give you the resize tool. Now with this, you can actually change the size of chest, so you can make it really tiny, or you can make it huge. Now this isn't going to change the storage space, and so this could be really cool if you want to go ahead and just, you know, have these chests hidden away really, really tiny, or with the robot chest man. He's kind of huge and can be very annoying if he's following you around, especially in caves or something. So you can go ahead and... Oh, I made him... Okay, I can't resize him without the key, guys. So, yeah, whoops. Messed that up. You need the key to resize... Can you not follow me? That's really creepy. Just, yeah, stay there, guys. Maybe we... I don't know. You might not be able to res... Oh, no, you can resize. You can resize him. You just need the key, guys. But with these ones, you don't. So we go ahead, resize. Boom, boom, boom. Back to normal size. The other thing you can do to modify these is with a wrench. Now, the wrench isn't exactly a modifier. It's a remover. So you can go ahead and use the chest here and remove it just like that. And you're going to be able to pick up the chest. Now, the best part about this is that when you do that, you don't have items going everywhere. They stay within the chest, which I think is really cool. So you guys can see, I can go ahead and dig this up. There aren't items going everywhere, even though I did actually put items in them. They're not going everywhere. They actually stay inside these chests. But anyway, guys, that brings us to the end of today's video. I'm glad we got to do this. We got to share this time together to check out a ton of awesome new chests. I really hope Mojang introduces new chests in the future. Boat chests. Why didn't people vote for Swamp? That's all I'm saying. But yes, I did say there was one extra secret step to get all these crafting recipes to work. All you gotta do, leave your world just like this, guys. And once you're in your world menu here, guys, you wanna go ahead and click the little edit icon. You wanna come down here to game and you want to turn on experimental gameplay. Now, once you turn it on, you can't turn it off. So as you can see, it's grayed out. But for you guys, you wanna turn that on. Then you wanna come down here to behavior packs and you'll see this more useful chest thing here. You wanna click that and click the plus button, and that will come up here to active behavior packs, and you want to do the same thing for the more useful chest resource pack. Now, if this more useful chest doesn't appear here for you, you guys can go ahead and download it from the link in the description below. It's really, really simple. Once it's downloaded, you just click it, open it, and it'll automatically install into your Minecraft, and you'll be able to get all these chests in your very own world. But anyway, guys, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one, and until then, EY Stream and my only friends, the chests, out. Bye! Just kidding, guys. I do have more friends than just chests. I hope. Please, are you guys?